Hello and welcome to this session. I'm Raghav and in this session, we are going to go very basic step by step and we will learn how we can check that our JSON is valid or how we can find any errors in the syntax or any issues with our JSON message or the JSON file. We will see a very quick demo on how you can use different tools online and find issues with your JSON message or your JSON file. In the last session, we had created this file demo.json and here you can see this is the data in this file. So we created these arrays and objects. So we have a users array which has all these objects and then we had subjects array and then we have all these data added. So just in case you have not watched the last session, you can go and see that if you do not have your JSON ready or if you have any JSON file or any JSON message, you can use that. So here, let us say I want to just check that this JSON is correct and there are no issues. So for that, I will go to Google and search for how to validate JSON. And here you can see I have got a lot of online tools available. There is JSON lint. Let me go here and I will also check for this JSON validator and free formatter. And let me check this one as well. And then this we have from Code Beautify. This will help us to beautify our JSON. So these tools will also help you to beautify your JSON or correct the formatting. So now let me show you one by one. I will copy the entire thing from here and I will go to this first tool which is JSON lint. Now in the description or the notes of this video, I will also provide all these links. So you can always check the notes and get all these links from there. I am pasting my entire JSON here and then I will click on this button validate JSON. And here you can see there is some issue. So here it says there is some error on line 22. There is a parsing error. So if I go to line number 22 and yes, you can see this is the subjects array. And here if you see after this first object, I did not give a comma and that is why there is this issue. So I should give a comma here and I will again say validate JSON and now it is saying this is a valid JSON. So this is the first thing. Let us see some more tools and you can then compare which is better. I will go to this JSON schema validator and again I will copy my JSON and paste it here and then you can see. So this is for schema. There should be a schema here. Now I will tell you about schema later. So this we do not need as of now because we do not have a JSON schema. We directly have a JSON message. And yes, this is the JSON validator. I will again copy my JSON and say validate JSON here. And let us see the output. So in this case, again, we are getting the issue. So it says the JSON input is not valid in JavaScript, missing a close square bracket after the list at line 29. So it says at line number 29, we have some issue, but this is not very good and it is does not give us direct information and does not also gives us the direct position like we could get here. So this is not very good, or if I compare with the earlier one, this is not very intuitive for me. Let me go to the JSON formatter and validator. I will again paste my JSON message and click on process and let us see the output here. And here you can see this is much better. It is saying that expecting comma or a closing square bracket and not this at this particular line. Now here if I click on this, you can also see it is highlighting this. So did you see it highlighted this? So when I click here, it is highlighting this here. This is very intuitive. It is actually giving us the exact issue. It is also showing us what is expected and is also highlighting exactly at what position we need to put this comma or a closing bracket. So here this is much better. And if I just go and give a comma here and now I will say process, and this time you can see this is a valid JSON. So this is much better. Then if I go to this JSON validator, and again I will paste my JSON and I will say validate JSON, and here again you can see it is giving us this issue, which is a parse error, and also it is giving us what is expected here and also giving us the position. So this is also better. Until now I have found this JSON formatter and validator the best until now. Now you can also beautify your JSON. So if you search for JSON formatter or JSON beautifier, let me search for JSON beautifier. So just in case you create your JSON without giving all these spaces, tabs and everything, you can always just copy your JSON and go to some JSON formatter or beautifier like this. So you can see there are so many tools online, and you just have to provide your JSON message here or JSON text here. So here I can give it like this. And here I can say beautify JSON. So there is a parse error, which we know that there should be a comma here. And now I will say beautify JSON, and it shows us the this version. And if I go here again, I will add my JSON and say beautify. Again, it is showing us this parsing error. I will give a comma here and say beautify, and you can see this is here. And I can also see a tree view here, which will show us the collapsed form, and then you can expand it like this. So all the objects and arrays, you will see they are now shown in a beautiful tree view, and this can be very handy. And this is how you can validate your JSON, and you can also check if there are any issues, and you can beautify your JSON. In the next session, we will learn how you can work with JSON paths and how you can create a JSON path. I hope this was very useful for you. I will meet you in the next session. Thank you for watching.